Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah.
I just wanted to know that regarding in the time of Aap sallallahu alaihi wasallam, azl and muta were permitted. Can you give a brief explanation regarding that?
What sister trying to ask a question, that at the time of the Prophet, azl means interruption of the sexual act, and muta, muta means temporary marriage. So these two were permitted. So can I give explanation on that? As far as this hadith that once a person came to the Prophet and asked Prophet that he's practicing this uzl, that is breaking of the act of sexual intercourse, the Prophet was silent. Based on that, there are two views, that because you're silent, that means he gave permission. Because you're silent, that he was not very happy on it. So there are two different views on that. Based on that, whether it's allowed or not, different views. But based on the other aspects of family planning, you can refer to my video cassette, Quran and Modern Science, Conflict and Conciliation, where I've given the answer in detail. So based on this hadith, some people said this can be done, some people said it's preferable not to be done, but no one can say it's haram. Doing that is not haram at all, this act per se. Come to the second part of the question, that at the time of the Prophet, muta was permitted? Yes. In the earlier part of his prophethood, at the time of the Prophet, in the early prophethood, even alcohol was not prohibited. In the early days of the Prophet, Prophet didn't prohibit alcohol. If you tell me that there were some sahabas who had alcohol in front of the Prophet, Prophet didn't say, I said, yes, that's fine. That was in the earlier part. Later on, the verses of the Quran were revealed prohibiting it. After that, there was never occasion which the person had alcohol from the Prophet and Prophet didn't prohibit it. Because if any wrong act is done from the Prophet, he will surely prohibit it if it's haram. So based on this, even muta was very much prevalent in Arab history. In Arab culture, it was very common. So an adultery, fornication was common. So it came in stages, all the prohibition. And in 7th Hijri, during the battle of Tabuk, at that time, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a couple of years before he died, he prohibited this. Now, when he prohibited it, those sahabas were present, they knew it very well. Amongst them was Hazrat Umar radiallahu anhu.